Hey there guys, welcome to this Dark Quest playthrough. We're going to have a quick look at this game and see what it's about. It's going to be coming out soon on Steam. I challenge you, damn it. Okay, so create a party of four heroes. Left click to select a hero and right click to view their abilities and attributes. Alright, so who's this guy? Barbarian. Well, how many can we pick? I'm not sure actually. Okay, oh, party of four heroes. Okay, so we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 we can choose from. Right, I feel like this guy could be really important. Weapon attack, 2 to 3 body damage. I don't want to spend too much time like looking into it too much. I want to just kind of get into the gameplay a little bit. A dwarf, you always need a dwarf. These numbers though, these guys are pretty weak. She looks pretty strong. Magic attack, well, let's do that. Okay. So we've got three so far. I guess we get this person, maybe the archer. Could be useful. Does this matter? Yeah, I think we need the archer really. Archer, all right. Nice mix here, I think. Exploration. Click on this window to learn more about exploration mode. Let's do that. Draw exploration cards from the hand until you reach the end of the deck. Strength, agility, intelligence, and perception. These are the average attributes of the party. For every 4 points per hero, it goes up by 1. The higher the number, the higher chance to succeed on a party attribute test. Interesting. Okay, open up your equipment cards, select a card, and then choose a hero to equip it. A hero may carry up to 5 pieces of equipment. Runes are special cards that are always active and affect the entire game. Party cards are consumable cards and can be used by all heroes in combat. Click on the wooden dice to roll the dice. If you're not happy with the result, you can use the white dice to re-roll. Okay, we know about that already. Alright. Let's get into it. The Elder nods as you approach. Adventurers, I have gathered you here to wish you well. Only you can stop the evil wizard and his chaos magic. Good luck. Receive a rune. Magic dice, once per area, you may re-roll the dice. 30% gold on adventure cards. Dice or cards? Dice or cards? Dice or cards? I feel like having a reroll is quite nice, so let's do that. Okay. Wagon merchant. The wagon merchant greets you warmly. Heroes, everything rests on you. Please take this armor to aid your quest. Okay, why not? Chainmail. 0 to 1 damage on body attacks. So do we want to have attack or defense? I feel like we want attack, right? So let's equip this on this dude. No, wait, actually. Oh no, because that increases the attack, maybe. I'm not sure. Anyway, alchemist. The alchemist ushers you over. Please, fellows, take a potion to strengthen you for the challenges ahead. Party card. Okay, gain 1 actions for this turn. Double damage on next weapon attack. Let's do double damage. May the spirits guide you on the path ahead. Venture forth and slay all those who oppose you. Alright, we need to build these guys up, these characters. We're in the Great Forest. Let's draw a card. Lady of the Lake. The ethereal Lady of the Lake emerges from the waters. The wizard's hubris has thrown my forest into chaos. How can I help you stop him? Let's draw a party card. Gain actions, double damage. Let's do double damage again. Forest Witch. You find an unkempt garden leading to a ratchery hut. An old witch emerges from within, shaking a satchel. Perhaps she has something for you. Ooh, add +2 damage on your next attack, or if your health is below 5, then heal for 3. Yeah, I think we do that. We don't have any potions like that yet, so... The forest comes alive as tendrils snake and lash towards you. Prepare yourselves. Okay. Oh crap.
Your first battle.
First battle. Click here to learn about combat. We just got hit. Okay, once a hero has completed their turn, the game will pick a monster to play. This will go back and forth until every character has played and the end of the round is reached. You can use F1 to F4 to select heroes and tab to cycle through them. The next monster to play is highlighted in a purple glow. Plan your strategy accordingly. Health. Changes are permanent. There is no maximum health. Armor and magic resistance provides extra health versus body and magic damage. They are set at the beginning of the battle. primary. Moving or using a primary card will end the character's turn. Secondary, you're allowed one secondary action before a primary action. How do you know if something's a primary or second? Okay. A processor only hover over the card. Cards with no action cost. Okay, that's free. Tip, 1 to 9 are hotkeys for each card. Okay. When two characters are adjacent to an enemy, they gain 1 plus damage on their attacks. Larger creatures such as 2v2 and very large 3v3 require 3 and 4 characters respectively. Okay. Most cards require a direction of attack. The arrow shows where a character will move to use that card. The edge of the tile determines the direction. Ranged attacks require a second position to move to. Pick the same tile again if you don't want to move. Okay. Most monsters attack their closest enemy, attack in a line, use spears, attack a random target, attack the highest health hero, and attack the lowest health hero, archers. Okay, okay. Once a hero has completed their turn, the game will pick a monster to play. Oh, we know that already. Okay. Right. So why don't we use this dude? The one in purple, I don't see a purple color though. That's red, so maybe go for that. I don't know. Ah, only 3 damage, damn it. Ooh, there's quite a few of these guys, aren't there? Jeez. Wait. Yeah, let's do a weapon attack. Oh no, that's not good. Guys, we're getting wrecked. Let's get rid of these mushroom things, man. Ah, come on, we need to kill them. I keep getting hit otherwise. Magic attack. Come on, yeah, let's attack that. Deal body damage to that, I think. Alright, nice, nice, nice. Only 1 damage? What the hell? This guy's dying, man. Okay, not a great start. I feel like the archer dude's dying. Oh, I could have used a health thing, right? Your party grows stronger, use your experience to upgrade a card or learn a new one. Or learn a new one. Let's upgrade a hero.
Select a character.
Like she's proper important, so creates a shield that blocks up to 3 damage. 1 health to a random ally when you get damaged. Oh, I like that. Let's upgrade that. Test River Crossing. Hero falls and receives 1 damage. Do we reroll that? I feel like we reroll that.
7.
Oh, phew, okay. It was only 1 damage though, to be fair. Thieves. A bunch of low-life thieves emerge from the trees. Must be tough trekking through here with all that stuff weighing you down. Let's lighten your load. Ooh, okay.
Test your party strength. 7.
Nice. Upgrade this hero. Do that. Oh, wait. Oh, okay, we have to actually upgrade.
Choose a hero.
Plus 2, that'd be nice, yeah. Perfect. So every time she gets hit, it heals someone else, which is very nice. Something unusual catches your eye behind the trees. Investigating, you find someone trapped in a hanging cage. They ask you to release them, explaining they are an apt lancer. Okay, rescue the lancer. Ooh, nice, new unit. Pack of wolves. Out of nowhere, a pack of wolves leap from the tree line and block your path, barring their teeth and growling. You won't be able to continue on this path without a fight. I don't know how big they are. Oh, there's a pack. There's probably quite a few of them. Holy smokes, they look strong. Okay. First of all, right, this guy needs to heal up. Nice. Okay, I think that was definitely worth it. That was going to attack next, so let's get rid of this one, I think. Maybe I should have got rid of the purple one, don't I? Okay, not bad. We got through the path. Didn't use too much. Let's upgrade a hero.
Choose a hero.
Plus three, nice. That'd be very nice. I feel like that's what we're going for here. Elder Treant. Okay, you meet a Treant in the forest that seems different from the others. Its body cracks as it unfurls, revealing some gifts. It waits for you to choose in silence. Heal a character for 5 to 7. Refuse and attack the Treant and acquire a rune. Now, the thing is, I don't really want to attack a Treant, right? Seriously, draw an equipment card. Do I heal or draw an equipment card? I feel like healing would be important here. He's the weakest, so heal him up. 10, nice, okay. We're looking pretty decent here, I think. Archer, Skull of Fate.
Roll the Skull of Fate.
Alright, Corn Archer, nothing happens. Yeah, I'm okay with that. You're startled by unusual sounds emerging from the trees and bushes beside you. Are they worth investigating? There may be treasure or worse. Okay, let's do it.
10.
Draw a party card, nice. Okay, double damage on next weapon, plus 2 attack, double damage. Ooh, blacksmith. Draw an equipment card, ask the blacksmith for better equipment, roll a 6 and above. Let's play it safe. Sword adds 0 to 1 body damage. Flail, okay, on body damage, body attack. Wait, what? Body damage abilities. Ooh, I like that. Give it to this dude. Leaf Forest. You have reached the edge of the forest. On the horizon, you see landmarks to explore. Where would you like to go? I guess we're going to the Undead Ruins.
Undead Ruins.
Very nice. Alchemist's Room. You find an old alchemist's table. Potions were mixed here, and the myriad stains and burns seem to connote that some were more successful than others. Add 2 plus damage on your next attack. Gains 1 action for this turn. Let's do that.
Test your party strength.
Okay, a large portcullis blocks the path forward. Your mighty heroes could lift it if you put your backs into it. Test your party strength to see what happens.
6.
Lift the gate and pass.
Dwarf,
throwing spears trap.
Perception.
Okay.
2.
Oh, damn. I feel like we re-roll that. I don't want to receive damage here.
2.
Damn it.
5.
Ooh, okay. At least it was quite expensive that though. At least we didn't take any damage, I guess. Room appears to be empty, but that only makes you more curious to uncover its secrets. Let's search
test
the room.
Your party perception.
You begin searching the room, looking for false bricks and cracks to reveal some amazing hidden treasure or passage. Roll the dice to see if you find anything.
7.
Find a party card, nice. Okay, I think we get the healing. We get the healing. Battle. You spy a horde of shambling undead monsters in the ruins. What will you do? I think we move around them. I don't really want to continue. We want to get our health up as much as possible, I think. Oh, dark offer. Sorcerer makes you an offer. Sacrifice one of your heroes and I'll give you 2,000 gold. A good deal? No? What's your reply? I refuse such an offer. Bookshelves. You feel a draft emanating from behind a large bookshelf. A secret passage, perhaps? You could move it to see what's on the other side. Let's do it.
Test your party strength. 7.
Nice. Okay, we press on. You find a stash of gold coins. Nice. Finders keepers. Sarcophagus. You stumble upon an aged, dusty sarcophagus. Someone important must have been there, buried there, and maybe their treasure along with them.
Test
open it up.
Your party strength. 5.
Okay, fine. What can you do? Battle. You spy a horde of shambling undead monsters. We're going to move around. Don't really want to fight that. Move around.
Lady, test your perception. 9.
Cool. She notices the trap. She moves around. Nice, nice. Okay, equipment room. This old keep has many rooms. This one is full of discarded equipment. You could probably find some useful weapons and armor if you search through it all. Let's draw an equipment card. Alright, what have we got here? Alright, so two options. Green amulet, where adds 0 to 1 on healing abilities or magic staff, 0 to 1 damage on magic attacks. I feel like we can use the green amulet. Like, that could go on the lady here. I don't know if that means that she can, like, when she gets attacked, that gets boosted to plus 4 health, maybe. I'm not sure. Claw trap.
Test your perception. 7.
Oof. Okay, we can't reroll anyway, so it's going to happen. Oh, he got hit quite hard. Damn, that sucks. Skull of Fate.
Roll the Skull of Fate. 1.
Oh, no. Okay. Bone Dragon. On the horizon, a large winged dragon is perched on a mound of gold and bodies. Lots of bodies. I think we're just going to continue there. I don't think we want to attack that big-ass thing. Cemetery, you reach the resting place of many heroes. Your prayers are answered. If your prayers are answered, you may bring back those who fell too soon. Well, we haven't lost anyone, so... Again, 2 dice rolls. Nice. Okay, that's good. Barrels. A handful of barrels are stacked in the corner of the room. You can break them to see if they have anything value inside. Break the barrels. Start to break the barrels. Who knows what's in this... Secrets. What secrets they hold inside. Okay.
7.
Nice, we've got some gold. Nice. Questionable provisions. To surprise, you find some provisions. Their mint condition seems odd in this place. It could be a trap or it could fill your bellies. Let's consume. Oh, right. Damn.
7.
Ah, nice. Heal the party. Oh, that's such a big bonus, guys. Look at that. Healed everyone there. Nice. Lion found him. The majestic feature may have provided water for the entire keep before it was abandoned many moons ago. Ooh, heal. This is looking great, guys. Looking great. Undead army. The armies of the undead have gathered in the pass that leads out of the ruins, preventing your exit. The only way forward is through them. You ready, weapons. Okay, I guess we gotta fight. What's this, anyway? Oh. Wait, what? Oh, those are runes. They stay with you forever. Party cards. Okay. It's fine. Let's go. Let's get in this fight then. Okay. So the purple one's going to be attacking next, right? So why don't we take him out? Ideally. Boom. Alright. This guy. Let's take this dude out. Ah, damn, didn't take him out though. It's a possibility we can take this guy out, so. Nice, we took him out. Good. Okay, so she's gonna attack now. 1 damage. We can get rid of that guy. Got 4 health and 5 health, so I want to take this guy out, ideally. Oh no, what? Okay, that's not good. I feel like he needs to drink some stuff here. Oh, not enough damage. Oh, he's gonna die. We need to get him out of here. I can't get him out of here. The healing potion. Right. Oh, that's trash. No, he's gonna die. Damn it. Okay, that's bad by me. That's bad. I should have helped save him. Oh, dear. Okay, we lost one guy. Create a hero.
Select a character.
Hmm. I feel like we should have got her closest and got the guy to come to go further away. We reach the end of the ruins. On the horizon, you see landmarks. To explore, goblin caves. Okay. Bit of goblin caves we go.
Case. The goblin vault. You will need a key to enter here.
Okay, can't do that anyway. Goblin merchant. Let's trade. Okay. What do we have here? Get some armor. Oh, I can't afford anything else. Damn, we don't have enough gold. Yeah, let's enter the tunnel, why not? Emptiest cave, okay, fine. Cluttered cave. You enter a cave that's piled floor to ceiling with junk. There could be valuables buried beneath the door. Roll the dice to see what happens.
Nine.
Nice, we get some gold.
I have an offer for you. What is your reply?
We only have 3 heroes left anyway, only, so I think we've got a run.
Test
I don't think
your party perception. 6.
Okay, we managed to escape, good, because we're already kind of one man down. We need to get to that kind of safe sanctity place, I don't know, where we can revive someone, basically, to run.
Test your party perception.
Try and run.
9.
Nice, we managed to escape. Looking good.
Dwarf, test your agility. 6.
Ooh, I mean, there's very little chance we're going to get there anyway, so he's going to be gone. Only 2 people in our party now. This is actually really bad. Do we enter it? Yeah, why not? Treasure cave, nice. Kind of regretted it after entering there, but. Rescue Savager. Nice, we've got a new hero. Okay. Oh, our guy's back.
Test your perception. 2.
Get caught in the web. Not sure what that does. Crap.
7.
Oof, okay, we lost quite a bit there. Tunnel passage? Yes, enter. Oh, damn. Let's run.
Party perception. 7.
Nice, we managed to escape. Perfect.
Lady, test your perception. 10.
Nice. She gets away with it. Battle. We're not taking any battles here. We need to revive this guy, I think.
8.
Nice, we escape. Perfect. Long spear.
Test your perception. 3.
Random hero. No, I feel like we can reroll that.
6.
Nice. Okay, that was worth it. Battle. You've entered a cave with a large number of goblins. Let's run for our lives again.
Test your party perception. 5.
Managed to escape. Perfect. We're doing well on that. Goblin witch. The witch shoots a toothless smile at you. She's pleased you agreed. Go ahead. Roll if you will. Win. If you win, I'll bless your weapons. If you lose, I'll curse them. She lets out a shriek laugh, covering you in a foul-smelling spittle? Spital? I don't know.
10.
Nice. Ooh, that's so good. Oh, but he's dead, so he's not going to get that. Let's enter the tunnel. Acquire a goblin hammer, why not? Well, she doesn't really have that much attack, so... No.
Archer, roll the Skull of Fate. 3.
Suffer 2. Nah, I'm gonna reroll that.
4.
Damn it. Gone all in.
5.
Okay, oh, God. We wasted 2 rolls on that. 8 gold.
5.
Ah, well. No value. We can't reroll anymore anyway. Okay, so we reached the end of the caves on the horizon. We're gonna go to the labyrinth. Nice.
Labyrinth. Dwarf, test your perception.
Okay, do we pass? 3. Do we pass? Disappear from the party. For one turn is not bad. I don't mind that too bad. That's just one turn, so it's fine. Mystery Woman. You come across a mysterious hooded woman. Hello, brave warriors. Tread carefully, for it's easy to lose your way in this place. Take this dice. May it guide you true. Nice, we've got 2 dice. Perfect.
Dwarf, test your perception. 5.
Cool, we pass. Intersection. You come across an intersection, you see 3 identical doors, nothing remarkable about them. Roll the dice to see which path you take.
6.
You enter a room with 1 monster. I mean, do we fight this? Yeah, I feel like we fight that. We'll take it. Six, okay. Let's go there for starters. So he gets boosted, nice. Weapon attack. Let's actually attack this dude now. Double damage. Wait, what? Can't I attack? Oh, okay. That's kind of bad. What does this do? Let's do that. Cool, cool. That's not too bad in the end, I guess. Shrine. A glowing shrine that stands in the entrance of the labyrinth. Why would a shrine have been built there? Ooh. Is it a trick? Revive a hero. I feel like we revive a hero here. Oh, is it only one health? What? I roll the dice to see how much health your hero will gain once they wake up. Ah, okay.
Six.
Okay, I feel that's fair. I mean, it's quite a large range there. 3 to 8. 9 to 10 is going to be hard to get, so... You've gone back. Come across an intersection.
Four.
One monster. We'll take that. We'll take that. That's fine. So we want to take him back. Like that. Oh, we could use a healing potion, actually. Let's take him back anyway. Okay, I don't mind him being attacked too much. So let's attack him. Nice. Attack. She attack as well, maybe? Okay. I kind of want him to heal up now. Yeah, nice. Good, good, good. That was a really good round for us, guys. That was a really good round for us. Intersection. Okay.
Seven.
Yeah, we can do that. We'll take another fight. Oh, I'm quite happy with this now. We can take a big fight here. Let's go and... if she gets hit, it doesn't matter too much because it kind of heals the rest of us. Like, he just got a massive buff there. Nice. So I feel like now we're going to attack with him. So if he gets attacked, it's not too bad. We've got the archer going to do a ranged attack here now anyway. Ooh, nice. This is really good. Okay, really good. Fallen Warrior.
Five.
Draw an equipment card. Very nice. Cloak of Resistance. +2 magic shields at the start of battle. Bear Belt. +2 strength. Let's get a Bear Belt. I feel like we should probably get it for this guy.
Lady, test your perception. 3.
Okay, disappear for one turn. I don't mind that too much. Just one turn should be fine. I don't think we'll use a roll for that. Skull of Fate.
Roll the Skull of Fate. 5.
Nothing happens. Okay, I'm okay with that. Fallen Warrior.
6.
Nice. Get a quick card. Leather Boots Agility or Armor? Let's get Armor. Who's going to give the Armor to? I feel like he needs it, maybe. He's got a strong Warrior now, isn't he? Yeah, he's a very strong Warrior.
Archer, test your intelligence. 4.
I mean, it's quite a large range, 1 to 7. I think even if we reroll that, we're going to get hit, so... He's kind of low on health now, which is not great. But I suppose it's the archer, so he'll be quite far back in fights anyway. Corridor, alright. Swinging axe.
Test your agility. 7.
3 to 4 damage. Oof. Okay, we'll take that. Ooh, that's actually bad.
Dwarf, test your agility. 5.
Oh my god, what is going on? We're getting killed here. Intersection, okay.
2.
Two more. I feel like we were rolling that one.
9.
Nice. We'll get away with that one. intersection again. Ten. Great, we continue, nice. Warren Warrior, okay.
Seven.
An equipment card, okay, what's it gonna be? Chainmail. Get chainmail again. This dude, I guess. Doesn't really have anything. Intersection again. Five. One monster. Yeah, I feel like that's okay. We can hopefully manage this one. So we're gonna go forward with this guy. Kick his ass. Oh damn, okay. He's got 10, so let's go forward and attack him. Attack. She can finish him off. Oh damn. Okay, that's fine. Okay, pretty nice, pretty nice. Intersection again.
Seven.
One monster, I feel like we can manage that. We'll tackle this guy first, I think, this time. I didn't do... Oh my god. She's getting hurt quite bad, isn't she? Let's use this guy to attack. I feel like she needs to heal, actually. Oh, we don't have any heals. Holy smokes. That's pretty bad. Oh, okay, we can get another attack. Nice. Okay, she's quite low on health. I'm a bit worried about that. Left or right. You reach a fork in the dungeon. You can go left or right. Roll the dice to see which way your party will go.
Six.
Nice. Fallen Warrior, can we get an equipment card?
Ten.
Nice. Bear belt, chain mail. Let's get another bear belt, I guess. Go to the archer. Minotaurs. As you walk deeper into the labyrinth, you come across a crossroads. Suddenly you hear footsteps and growls from every direction. Prepare for battle. We don't have a choice. Oh my god, there's three minotaurs here. What? No, there's four. Oh my god, this is going to be bad. We are going to lose some lives here, I think. So, this is going to attack next, no matter what. I don't think we can kill him. So if we can get one of these out, that'd be ideal. Why don't we try and take out this guy? What is that? Is that four armor? I think that's four armor, isn't it? Try to get rid of this guy. Holy smokes. Oh my god, the archer's dying. I don't think we can get through this one. Oh no, guys. Yeah, I think we're dead on this one. Wow. We just got absolutely wrecked, guys. I think we're dead here. Yeah, we're dead now. My god, this is a really hard level, honestly. Not too sure what we could have done different. But yeah, we're dead now. Yeah, we got rid of one of them. So I think it's over. Yeah.
You are no match for my magic.
Ouch. Well, guys, I mean, that was actually really fun. Do check out the game on Steam. Should be available probably by the time you're watching this, maybe. But yeah, if you did like this video, do give it a thumbs up. I really enjoy the game. It's going to be fun, I think. I'd probably see myself playing this again and try and get to the end. I think we got quite far, though. I feel like on my first playthrough, we got quite far. I'm not too sure what we could have done differently. I mean, our heroes are pretty strong. I don't know, guys. That was really tough. But anyway, all right. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Take care, guys, and see you next time.